Good evening, everyone. We welcome you to the first session of the practical use of plant subclass and superclass. It's an opportunity to learn from Dr. Shankaran live. He had done this a decade earlier in WWR1, Wednesdays with Rajan 1. Now we have this great opportunity again to learn from Sir. So let me give you a brief about what this session is. So this is the latest course by HMP, Homeopathic Medical Publishers, named The Practical Use of Plant Subclass and Superclass. And this is the first live session. So this course will consist of 20 hours of video lectures, which can be viewed as per your convenience. And also, complimentary, you will get 4 live sessions with Dr. Rajan Shankaran on the first Sunday of each month. There you will have the opportunity to ask your doubts and queries to Sir and get them answered. So the first course in this plant subclass and superclass series, Sir had thought about the basic introduction of the plant subclasses, the evolution of the subclasses, and the relation between subclasses and superclasses. And now in this course, Sir will enhance our knowledge and teach us further about plant subclasses and superclasses, and especially about the fourth and fifth subclass and superclass in detail with many, many cases and many newer remedies. This is the syllabus in short, and here are the dates for the live sessions of the next 4 months. This course you will have access for 5 months after the activation date. Now, many people will have a query that what was the first course about? So the first course was Plant Subclass and Superclass 1, which is available on our HMP website as a video course. In that, Sir has taught us about the 6 subclasses of the dicots, and he had made us understand the characteristic pattern of reaction of all these subclasses. He had also made us understand the other kingdoms from mineral and animal, the other groups from the mineral and animal kingdoms, and how we can understand the superclasses in relation to the botanical subclasses. That video series is of 21 hours, and it represents the next step in the development of the sensation method and is proving most valuable in practice to the people who have already watched it and are using it in practice. All the talks are video recorded and you can watch them as per your convenience, and that is of 4 months.
From here, you can go to the rubrics now. From here, you can go this. I've used the new Synergy homeopathic software that is a development of the MAC repertory and reference works. And I've used the graphs from there. You can see how it brings you through these graphs. It brings you to the sapindalis and then to the anacardiaceae. And you can see the rubrics of the child. The cough rubrics, cough violent, cough lying in bed, cough convulsive, spasmodic, the vomiting. And you can see anacardium, one of the remedies coming up in all the rubrics. And then you can see here also, interesting, when you go from there into the limited to the anacardiaceae family, you can see anacardium is the main remedy, which has all these symptoms of the child. And then you see the history of the mother during pregnancy. Again, by the graphs, you can still come to anacardiaceae, and you can see the hemorrhage, uterus, metrorrhagia, and the pain in the hips. Lying aggravates, walking ameliorates, and you can see turning in bed. And you can see also that in this graph also, you can see Roostox that is coming second, which is from the same family. You see, and also a little bit of anacardium. And then when you see the mother's dreams and the mental state, you can see the delusion that there is someone in bed with him, disgusting, devils, persecuted, religious, trapped, going to be attacked. And you can see anacardium orientale coming strong from the mother's, you know, dreams during the pregnancy. Now, when you take the symptoms of the stepfather, also interestingly, that he has got sadomasochism, perversity, obscene, dictatorial, unfeeling, abusive, jealous, lascivious, malicious, alcoholic. you find the main remedy also anacardia. It's very interesting. Sometimes you see the aggressor and the victim are parts of the same remedy. It's very, very interesting. I found it so often. So in this way, you can see the cancer and the leprosy miasm in the mother and in the child. And so you can see also in the graphs of the various miasms also, you can find it. Miasm of the stepfather, etc. I'm not going into too many details, but you can. So the remedy we gave was anacardium orientale.